Hey, what's up guys, in this video we're breaking down the 5 best projectors in 2021 on the market. Without further ado, let's get started. And by the way, links to all the featured products are given in the description below. There are many factors to think about when choosing the best projector for you. Below are the most important ones, which we considered while we were researching this list. The best projectors in this video all offer some level of portability too. This is a huge pro of choosing a projector instead of a big TV. It means you can get an immersive movie watching experience 1 minute and then have the projector tucked away nearly in a closet or on a shelf the next. Although it's worth pointing out that many 4K projectors look good, so there's no problem leaving them out on display if you have room. So, lo and behold, here are our favorite projectors of 2021. The fifth product on our list, ViewSonic M2 1080p, most versatile, with a native resolution of 1080p and a brightness rating of 1200 ANSI lumens. This LED projector is capable of performing the job of a home cinema projector perfectly well, and it's also small and light enough to throw in the supplied carry bag and take on holiday with you. The image quality is excellent. Movies and TV shows are packed with vibrant colors and crisp details, thanks to greater than sRGB color reproduction and HDR support. It's super easy to set up too, with both autofocus and auto keystone correction kicking in automatically whenever you move the projector, and audio quality is surprisingly punchy with the projector's 3W Harman Kardon speakers pumping out rich, full-bodied audio. Connectivity is what you'd expect, with HDMI 2.2 and USB-C catering for video sources plus a USB-A and a micro SD slot for video file playback. The projector even has its own storage built in, with 10GB available for any video files you might want to store permanently. The fourth product on our list, Optima HD 146X, most compact, a less expensive but still excellent projector as the Optima HD 146X and shares many of the same specs as the Epson 2150. The biggest difference is that it's a DLP projector, so its rated 3600 lumens of brightness don't make it brighter than the 2150. The Optima's image modes are also less flexible, and the bright mode produces an unusably green image. The vivid or cinema modes are much nicer, but if you're viewing in the middle of the day, you'll likely need to put your shades down, especially if you don't have a screen. In addition, the HD 146X offers nice contrast, which produces a punchy image. Lastly, the HD 146X's built-in 3W speaker is not loud, but the fan is loud. At maximum volume, you can still hear the fan if the projector is near your head. It's manageable, though if this projector is for your bedroom, the speaker will be fine. But if you're trying to do a movie night with friends or you have loud street noise, I'd recommend speakers, which you can hook up through a 3.5mm audio output. The 1.1x zoom lens has a shorter range than the 2150, so it's hard to make the image really big in apartment. At 11 feet away, the image is about 100 inches, which is big, but wish it could get even bigger. The third product on our list, Sony VPLVW295ES, most valuable. Sony makes some of the best projectors on the market today, and the VPLVW295ES is no exception. It's the least expensive 4K model in Sony's lineup, offering true native 4096 by 2160 resolution. And even at its relatively low price, you still get a fully motorized lens with memories, making setup for different kinds of content, TV shows, widescreen movies, etc. With a 225W lamp, the VPLVW295ES offers a peak brightness of 1500 lumens, which is plenty for high dynamic range content in the HDR10 and HLG formats. And that lamp is rated to last up to 6000 hours, which is much longer than many lamps. Sony does not specify a dynamic contrast ratio for this projector, but its SXRD imaging panels assure deep blacks, which is essential for HDR. Other outstanding features include 9 calibrated picture modes for super accurate images in any environment and support for IMAX enhanced content, which brings the majesty of IMAX into your home. It also lets you enjoy 3D content with its built-in 3D transmitter that works with industry standard RF glasses. The second product on our list, Epson 3800 4K Pro UHD, best quality. This is a great projector that makes Epson very competitive at this end of the best 4K projector market. But it gives a great picture which belies the price. Colors are impressive for wide landscapes or close-ups of faces, and although there are some of the problems with blacks lacking depths which projectors often suffer from, you'd have to be quite pernickety to spot it. While there aren't any frame interpolation options on 4K level settings, motion blur is low and action remains smooth. Even when switched to the 1080p modes, there's a fantastic picture, plus many extra settings to reduce any blur even further at this resolution. The option of Bluetooth audio output means you don't need to have quite so many wires trailing across the room if you've run a soundbar under the projected image. However, there are some practical niggles: the onboard controls are a little cluttered, and the dials for lens shift are a slightly strange way to employ this feature. But once you've set it up and you're staring at the beautiful image, these minor issues will be quickly forgotten. The first product on our list, BenQ 850 Takas 4K HDR Pro, best overall, the BenQ 850 Takas is a 4K projector for your living room, with boosted audio, intense 3000 lumens brightness, and a focus on sports broadcasts to help it stand out from the piles of other projectors out there. Exceptional HDR, and the addition of a motion smoothing and contrast heightening sports mode for those wanting to watch the football on a large projection, the 850 Takas make a strong argument as the best BenQ projector we've seen. The BenQ 850 Takas can output 3000 lumens of brightness, making for vividly realized colors and immediately visible detail, even in daytime or with some level of ambient light in the room. For that, it get a thumbs up from us. Buyer's Guide. Projector Brightness. Projector brightness is measured in ANSI lumens. Home theater projectors generally start out at about 1000 lumens and range upwards to 2500 lumens and more. Your viewing environment is the deciding factor on how many lumens your projector needs. Dedicated home theaters, rooms with controlled lighting and no ambient light, will not require as much brightness as a space with ambient light from windows or other household lighting. Image quality. Currently, wide XGA, 1280x800, and HD, 1920x1080, are the most common home theater projector resolutions. An HD, 1920x1080, projector has about twice the number of pixels of a wide XGA projector. More pixels mean a sharper looking image and better compatibility with high definition sources. Aspect ratio. Because projectors are a fixed resolution display device, they have what is called a native aspect ratio. The most common aspect ratios for projectors are 4:3, 16:10, and 16:9. That means that the chip inside the projector is shaped in the specified 4:3, 16:10, or 16:9 proportions. Think of the chip as a miniature version of the image you will see on your screen. Lamp life. LCD and DLP projectors typically have a lamp life between 2000 to 4000 hours. This specification is actually referring to the half-life of the lamp, the point where the lamp is half as bright as it was new. The lamp will still work at its half-life, but it will continue to gradually lose brightness. Longer lamp life means less expense in maintaining your projector. Additional features. We've rounded up our favorite projectors, including full HD and native 4K models, which also support HDR, and some short-throw projectors too for those with smaller spaces. There are even one or two portables that would make an excellent bring-along addition to a garden party for an outdoor cinema experience. The only question is how much do you have to spend? A projector may be best thought of as an inverted camera, spitting light out of a lens rather than receiving it. Thanks for watching, and that's all for this video. If you like this video and it helped you out in any way, please give the video a like and hit that subscribe button. Take a moment to hit the bell icon so you'll get notified of all our new latest uploads. Hope to see you guys in the next video. Till next time, I'll see you later.